Shipping keeps the gears of the global economy turning throughout the year. But there's a major challenge that some shipping routes face. Ice. Yes, ice can create hurdles for ships, especially in places where it gets really cold. How do we keep those routes open and accessible? Well, that's where our heroes come in. Specialized icebreaker ships. These incredible vessels play a vital role in breaking down the icy barriers, making way for smoother and safer shipping. Welcome back to Nautical Depths, and today we are going to explore the world's most powerful icebreaker, Arktika. So, without further ado, let's start today's nautical adventure. Icebreaker ships are a special kind of ship made to break even the thickest ice and open up paths that are usually really tough to travel. They do this especially in the super cold polar regions, where the waters are covered in ice. What makes these ships stand out are their strong hulls that can handle icy waters, a special shape to clear the ice, and powerful engines to move through sea ice. The idea of icebreaker ships has been around for a very long time. It dates back to the days of exploring the polar regions as far back as the 11th century. Back then, they were more like boats. The early icebreakers, called kochi, were created by the communities living on the coasts of the Arctic Ocean. These small wooden ships were used to navigate through icy waters of the Arctic seas and Siberian rivers. They had special features like a tough outer layer to protect the ship from ice and a rounded shape under the water to help it pop up if squeezed by ice. As time passed, new icebreakers were made with similar designs. Even today, their basic design is the same, but with modern upgrades, making them more efficient. Nowadays, icebreakers have important jobs like clearing paths for trade routes in icy waters, especially during winters. Although some ships are designed to handle icy waters, seasonal ice conditions can make it tough for them. That's where icebreakers come in. They guide commercial ships through these areas to make sure they navigate easily. Besides helping ships, icebreakers also play a big role in supporting research programs in the polar regions. In the late 1980s, Russian experts worked on creating a new nuclear-powered icebreaker. They wanted to replace the older Arktika-class ones from the 1970s with the new ones. This was part of a plan to update the icebreaker fleet after the Soviet Union broke up. The new icebreaker would have 60 megawatts of power and a special feature called dual draft. It was supposed to let it work in shallow coastal areas when it's not carrying a heavy load. Even though they first started thinking about it almost 20 years earlier, the design for the ship was completed in 2009. It was named Project 22220 by the Central Design Bureau, Iceberg. The Baltic Shipyard in St. Petersburg started building the first one in August 2012. More contracts in May 2014 and August 2019 mean that there are now five Project 22220 icebreakers being built or planned. As of April 2022, the Russian government plans to spend 118 billion rubles to make two more Project 22220 icebreakers, expected to be ready in 2028 and 2029. The Baltic Shipyard won the contract to build the first Project 22220 icebreaker on August 3, 2012, with a value of 36.959 billion rubles, around 1.16 billion US dollars. Construction officially began with a steel cutting ceremony on November 1, 2012, and the keel was laid on November 5, 2013. By August 2015, 70% of the hull, including the icebreaker bow, was done, and everything was on track to finish by December 2017. The planned launching ceremony, originally set for May 2016, took place on June 16, 2016. They named the new icebreaker Arktika, which means the Arctic in Russian, following the tradition of its predecessor. While the hull was still being put together, the shipyard started building the 2,400-ton superstructure that would be added after the launch. The 180-ton RITM-200 nuclear reactors were also installed after the launch. The first one on September 2, 2016, and the second one on September 21st. All right, now let's talk about the impressive design of the Arktika icebreaker. This incredible ship is gigantic, measuring a whopping 569 feet in length overall and 525 feet at the design waterline. To put it in your perspective, this ship is as long as around 1.5 football fields. Now, when it comes to width, at its widest point, it reaches 112 feet in total. But here's the cool part. The hull's width reduces to 108 feet at the design waterline due to some slick inclined sides. Why is this so important? Well, it lets the vessel smoothly sail through both shallow Arctic River estuaries and along the Northern Sea Route. This incredible icebreaker can vary its draught, which is how deep it goes in the water, by taking in or letting out ballast water. Originally, it was designed to operate with a draught range of 25 feet, 11 inches, to 34 feet, 5 inches. But guess what? It can now handle a bit deeper waters, with the minimum operational draught increased to 28 feet, 5 inches. Now let's talk numbers. At its original minimum draught of 28 feet, this icebreaker weighs around 25,540 tons. But when it is fully loaded, at its design draught, it can hit a whopping 33,530 tons. To give you some perspective, this amazing ship is 45 feet longer and 13 feet wider than the previous world's largest icebreaker, 50 Lit Pobody. When fully loaded, it has about one-third more weight. What about its ice class? Well, this powerful icebreaker boasts the highest ice class, Icebreaker 9, assigned by the Russian Maritime Register of Shipping. This means it can power through ice as thick as 13 feet during the winter and spring navigating period. This ship is not just big, it is breaking records and barriers, which is simply incredible. Let's dive into the amazing power and propulsion system of this icebreaker. Just like its nuclear-powered predecessors, this ship follows the same nuclear turbo-electric powertrain concept that's been around since the iconic Lenin in 1959. Nuclear reactors produce steam for turbo generators, which then create electrical power for the propulsion motors that drive the ship's propellers. Now, let's talk reactors. The onboard nuclear power plant boasts two RITM-200 pressurized water reactors, each with a thermal output of 175 MW. Developed by OKBM Afrikantov, these reactors use up to 20% enriched uranium-235. They're efficient too, operating with a capacity factor of 0.65. They only need refueling every 7 years over a planned service life of 40 years. The plant itself has dimensions of 6 by 13.2 by 15.5 meters and weighs 1,100 tons. Two powerhouses produced by Kirov Energomash, each cranking out 36 megawatts of electrical power at 3,000 RPM. Now let's explore how this icebreaker moves in the water. Its propulsion system follows the classic polar icebreaker setup with three shaft lines and a single rudder. Picture this, 6.2 meter four-bladed propellers, each powered by a 20 megawatt electric motor. These massive propellers, made of stainless steel, weigh about 60 tons each. With a total propulsion power of 60 megawatts, this icebreaker outshines its predecessors, making it the world's most powerful icebreaker ever made. When it comes to breaking through ice, this vessel is simply unstoppable. It is designed to break 2.8 meters of thick level ice at a continuous speed of 1.5 to 2 knots at full power. When it hits open water, it can cruise at a remarkable 22 knots. In a nutshell, Arktika Icebreaker stands as a technological marvel, pushing the boundaries of exploration and navigation in icy terrains. From its powerful nuclear turbo engines to its impressive capabilities of breaking thick ice, this vessel redefines what's possible in polar exploration. For more videos like this, subscribe to Nautical Depths and hit the bell icon to stay updated.